Hello, my name is Antonio Pinion, and my attendant major is a future aerospace engineer. My problem is about chiropractors needing a new way to train, because like they have, only way they have to train is like real electrical tools, like activator guns that they actually put in their spines. And the biggest problem they have out of that is like they hurting each other because they're applying too much pressure or they're doing it way too long. And I wanted to have them come up with like a fun invention that they can just like do what anybody, kids can do it, adults can do it, and actual chiropractors can do it. So, this topic was choosing because, they only had two options to choose between. I had to choose between like making a function that acts as a spine or making a laser that detects if you have washed your hands, and I'm not that good with the electric and lasers and all of that. So I was like, let me try something different. Barely hear anything about chiropractic inventions or chiropractors themselves. Alright. Justifications. The justification that this actually needs to be built for me was basically because my advisor was like, oh, we need to do this because like chiropractors, they don't have any way to train them besides those tools, and the tools are like $300, $400 a day. They don't have a cheap way to train. It's like very expensive. You have to have a good job to buy a dog job.
Alright, the assistant products, like I said, they have the aggregator tool spines, but they just put it on their spine and they just have to find the most painful spot for the patient and they'll like just put it back in place and all of that. And the most simplest one, which everybody might even know, is like a chiropractic table, which is like all of those are mechanical. Like, that one's mechanical and those are electrical. That's the only mechanical one that they really train on, which they lay on and they're like, they can sit up on it, or they can twist this way, or twist this way, which is another expensive one. That one's like $1,000.
All right, my construction method.
My construction method was, it was everywhere because I had to put this together. Like I had to find the materials that I wanted to build it because I really wanted to do like a far-fetched invention with it, like invent a 3D printed spine and put a test dummy, get a test dummy and put a spine inside of it. I had to come down there just because my time was ticking fast. So I came up with my 3-2-1. Alright, so my materials were cardboard, hot glue, and popsicle sticks. And my prototype wasn't really nothing. It was basically two rectangle cardboard boxes, and that was basically it. So. Oh yeah, and it wasn't just that, it was a lot more than that. It took me a lot of chances to like have to actually get the rotation in, because this apartment is an excellent spine and actually rotates if you're stretching or something like this. So it took me a lot of tries to actually get the rotation part without like breaking the popsicle sticks or messing it up a lot. Alright. The testing data. Since it was cardboard, I had a big problem with it like being able to apply, like having a lot of pressure on it, because cardboard is not that strong. Like I could have did plastic, but plastic was like isn't that strong either. So I was just like, oh, I'm just go with the cardboard and come up with a modification that will be able to hold it tight together and not over bend. So my modification, I actually used the popsicle sticks. It was like a last second idea. I was like, oh, I need to come up with something that can hold this together and be actually strong. So I was thinking around, I was like, popsicle sticks. And I was trying to cut them. I was like, man, these things are hard to break or bend. You can't really bend them because they're strong. So I was like, all right, I'm going to just use my popsicle sticks as beams. Like, I have my popsicle sticks inside of there, like this, when they're like in layers. So you can barely put pressure on it. It won't break at all. Like, unless you're intentionally trying to break it on purpose, like actually find like signal or something. Other than that, it holds together very well. Alright, my product of people, it acts as a spine. It's like, that's the main function of it. It doesn't look like the spine at all, like, not at all, right, you know. But gives you the rotation of turning like one of the most famous stretches, like going like this with your spine and it rotates. So I really wanted to, my main idea, like my main purpose was really to get the function into the project. I wasn't really worried about the looks because the looks could come on later as I continue with the product.
How does it solve the problem?
It allows chiropractors to have fun. It's not meant to be so serious, taken serious as like, I mean, I take it serious, but it's not like a real spawn. Like a real spawn that you can actually train or cost like $500 like the other, which is, you can have fun with it. Like, it's pretty simple. Anybody can do it. Little kids, grown-ups, like I said earlier. They might want to grow up and be a chiropractor one day. They might see this and be like, oh, this is fun. I can go build this. They can do a DIY video or something like that. All they have to do is have hot glue and cardboard and just make two boxes and have a rotation if possible. All
right. Who will buy your model?
Chiropractor. My invention was basically for chiropractors, but I was like, man, this is way too simple for chiropractors to actually want to go buy this in this prototype right here. So I was like, well, I'm going to just sell it to kids since I've been talking about kids the whole time. I'm going to try to sell it to kids so they want to be chiropractors or don't want to know what they're doing in the future.
One market price.
I made it $15 because I didn't want it to be too cheap. I was like, all right, it takes time. It actually takes quite a time. Well, if you know what you're doing, you can build it very quick. But I wanted to make it $15 because you can just buy any of these, all this product. Prices for this stuff was like $2, $3, and the cardboard, I bought a lot of cardboard, it was like $5. So the prices came up to $10, so I was like, I'm going to just add $5 so I can make a profit.
Alright, there goes my cost of products. It was
my glue gun sticks were $247, my cardboard was $395,
and my popsicle sticks was $269,
like I said, very cheap once again.
What I learned, alright.
An invention doesn't have no limit on how spectacular it is. Only thing that matters about an invention is do you love it? And do you really like think that you can make it better? And that's all I think that this invention is. Alright, I want to give a big thanks to Ms. Vientia and Zach for giving me this idea and telling me what I need to do and pressuring me to actually finish this project.